What's going on, guys? Today I'm going to show you some footage from a tournament in 2009. I hope you all will enjoy this video, so let's get started. Alright, first I want to talk to you guys briefly before getting into the specific fights of this tournament, but I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the first match. I'm going to go ahead and let that play over while I talk. This first match, I was a first degree black belt at this tournament. First match was against a third degree black belt. She was out of state. I'm not really remember where she was from, but pretty much everyone I fought was out of state. There were a lot of people that came to this local tournament just from surrounding states, a lot of really good schools, good fighters. It was a double elimination tournament, so you had to lose twice before you were out. So that meant you got to fight quite a bit, especially if you kept winning or if you won a lot. You got a lot of fights in. So that's why a lot of people really like this tournament. It was just a great way just to get a bunch of experience in and in a tournament setting as well. I will go ahead and say this, looking back at the footage now, even more so now than then, I can definitely tell I was such a sloppy fighter back then. So sloppy. I would fall down a lot on my spinning kicks and my head kicks. I would just fall down. I just didn't keep my balance very well. And also when I would get into a jam, I would push off a lot. You know, that's just something during the fight. That's something I didn't even think about. I didn't even realize I was doing it so much during the fight. Looking back at the footage, I'm like, man, I was pushing off and grabbing and all this other stuff. During the fight, I didn't think about it. I didn't even realize I was really doing it. And that's just something over time, I was able to start fighting with a more clear mind rather than letting the adrenaline take over. So that was definitely one big improvement that I've seen from back then to 2013 when I last competed. I fought with a more clear mind. I was more aware of what I was doing. I didn't let the adrenaline take over so much. And that's just something that's just gonna happen with experience. I mean, I was a black belt, you know, in this tournament in 2009, but I was also a black belt in 2013, and there was just a big difference. Just a big difference. It just takes a lot of time, a lot of experience, and a lot of training just to get to that level, just to be able to fight with a clear mind and not let that adrenaline take over. But overall, this was an awesome tournament. That's why I wanted to share it with you guys. I will say that I fought 6 times during this tournament, which is quite a bit. Typically, I only fought maybe like three to four times max at tournaments. So fighting 6 times at this tournament was quite a bit for me, and I think it's quite a bit just on average fighting in a Taekwondo tournament. Usually don't fight quite that much. But let's go ahead and start talking about the specific fights. Let's move into the second fight. So the second fight of the tournament, I fought this girl. I think she was from Atlanta. She was from a really good top school in Atlanta. She was really good. I'd never fought her before. She was really quick. She kept getting me on the speed. I did lose to her in this match. When we would get into a jam, she would like get out and throw that defensive round kick really fast to get me on the speed. And I was fighting a little sluggish, sloppy, like I said before. But she was a lot quicker. She was just getting that shot in before I could get my shot in, and that's how she beat me. The next 2 matches, I pretty much had to fight my way out of the loser's bracket. So I'd already lost once. If I lost one more time, I was out of the tournament. So this is me fighting my way out of the loser's bracket. These next 2 fights, I had to really just kick it up a notch and just try to just not lose, just win. And I did feel like as the tournament progressed, as I kept fighting, I actually kept fighting a little bit better compared to my first and second fight. Like as the tournament went on, I started fighting better, which was kind of strange. Usually you would fight, someone's fight worse because your energy's draining, but I actually fought better as the fights went on. And then we made it to the 5th match of the tournament for me. I had to fight the girl who beat me in the 2nd match. So here's how it was. We get to match number 5, okay? It's just me and this girl left in the division. She hasn't lost at all. I've lost once. All she has to do is beat me one time and we're done. She gets first place, I'm out, we're done. I have to beat her twice, two times in a row. She's already beat me once earlier in the day. Okay, so we get into the first, fifth match, start fighting, and I start picking up on her getting back and trying to slip in that quick counter. I started picking up on it a little bit more, registering it. You know, I already fought her once, so I knew she was a little bit quicker, so I just had to time my kicks a little bit better. And that's what I started doing. I ended up coming back. I beat her in the fifth match. So here we are, match number six. This is our final match. Whoever wins this goes home with first place. We have both lost to each other in this tournament, so we just both just put it on the line. I fought my little heart out, came back with first place. And the reason this tournament was so memorable for me was the fact that, one, I fought six times. This was the most I've ever fought in a tournament. And two, I basically fought my way out of the loser's bracket the whole tournament. I lost my second match, and then I was just having to just keep fighting to stay in the tournament the rest of the time. And, you know, going from losing to have to dig deep and really come back and actually win and take the whole thing, that's just a really great feeling, really good accomplishment. And that's when I kind of felt that I really did truly enjoy fighting. I truly just enjoyed sparring. I enjoyed tournaments, and that's the most important thing. You want to make sure that you enjoy fighting, you enjoy the tournament, or why are you doing it? I mean, you want to make sure that you're having fun, and I definitely had fun. You know, I mean, I already knew there was a chance that I could have lost the whole tournament after losing the first time, so I just went out there, fought my best, had fun, and from then on out, I started to really, really truly just enjoy fighting, which is what you all should always do. Just think about going out there, having fun, do your best. If you come home with first place, that's just another great perk, a great bonus, taking home that first place. I do hope you all enjoyed this video. I'm going to do my best to try to find some of my other old Taekwondo footage, especially when I first started out, just so you guys can see that and so I can see that again as well. Also, make sure you leave me a comment down below on what topic you want to see me talk about in the next talking video. Don't forget to subscribe, like us on Facebook, follow me on Instagram. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I will see you later.